Jesus said to her, "Thy brother shall rise again." Look at your neighbor, say this once. Look at him and say,
neighbor,
nothing's too hard for God to bring back for you. Say this for me. Nothing's too hard for God to bring back for you. What was the preach master? I feel it on me. Amen. I wonder, Professor, some of you, praise God, for the first time, you watch my live stream, you watch the live stream, you told in the morning in the ministry here in Nassau, amen, in Portia Arena, in the beautiful 242. So please feel free to email us, pastor157@msn.com, or bornagainministry@yahoo.com. For you, praise God, maybe hearing this word for the first time, but not say you. Be mindful, man. Amen. Let you get into your spirit and get into your heart. And we are in the season of the Lord's restoration. What I said? The Lord's restoration. What somebody suggests to you is that it's not going to be the work of a man, but it is the work of God. Amen. If you got any kind of inkling of spirituality, you can see that God has been restoring us from the last 6.5 years. And some of you may think he's moving too slow, but I can say to you, he's moving right on time. I promise you, praise God, when that bell ring 2021, 2021, you will have seen what God has done just in this year alone. Amen. Will make up for all the years that have been in slow motion. Preach, Pastor Miller. I think I got to encourage myself here. And so, amen. You got to get in your mind that we are in the season, and it's not because of us. But because God promised Abraham, there's a time of restoration going to come to his seed. And if you are Christ, then you are Abraham's seed. That's the question then. What is a Nazeo? Well, amen. A Nazeo is in the Greek word for the word, "This my son was dead, is alive again." It talks about recover of life, to, amen, to be alive again, to live again. And I don't know if some of you, praise God, life seemed to have dumped you, slipped out on you, walked out on you, chested and pushed out on you. Amen. I submit to you, life is about to come back again. Someone holler again. Amen. We promise you, amen, we will experience the Nazeo. Amen. So the question is, who will experience the Nazeo? Here's the answer. Those who believe in their heart that God is going to bring some things back. Just in case I'm in the wrong building tonight, I need to get a right Sunday on the street. If you believe God will bring some things back to you, shout and say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All right. To talk to five of y'all, you got to believe in your heart that's meant to you. And those who despise this hour and season, instead of watching every time, going to see a distraction with God. Amen. If you don't believe his word, he'll cut it from you. Amen. Until you catch yourself and believe. When the season of time, I'm not saying, oh, amen. I'm not saying, it's the season of time of the re. What did I say? Of the reed. It's of the reed. In Joel chapter number 2, Joel said that I will restore to you the years of the locust of Eden and the cankerworm, the caterpillar, the palmerworm, my great army which I sent upon you. And the word there is reed. Say restore, restore, restore. Everybody who have lost something need a reed in your life. I submit to you upon the apostolic anointed tonight that reed will re-engage again in somebody like you. You have started to have a return on something, but it can slow down the car when it causes you to climb back up again. I preach, but I feel like preaching this. And so, amen, you are in the season, the time of God's restoration, God's revival, God's refreshing, amen, God's rebirth, and God's renewing it all over again. As I agree with you, my time is going. I got to run the text tonight. Look at people. You pass through the town of Bethany, the town of Martha, Mary, and their brother Lazarus. Say, preach, my love. What happened was, amen, these are not no average people. These are no average Joe Blow. These are the friends of Jesus. Anybody here got Jesus for a friend? These are the friends of Jesus. And there's some things I want to observe here and bring it to you as I see it in the screen. Now, the first thing I want you to observe, amen, is that not because you are the friend of Jesus don't mean you're going to have no problem. Amen. One of the biggest deceptions is to think after you get saved, the devil going to run and tuck his tail between his legs. The devil is a liar. I mean, amen. When you put that anointing of Jesus on you, you attract attack. And amen. You can testify, praise God, the hell you went through in salvation. Folk didn't bother you when you wasn't in it. But amen. Can I say to you, praise God, that no matter what you go through, God is on your side. Praise God. The scripture opened by saying that a certain man was sick. What's his name, Pastor? His name is Lazarus. Which Lazarus? Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary and his sister Martha. Anytime you are highlighted and exposed like that, it's because you are known to God. Amen. It's about to be glorified in you. And everybody may know what you went through, what you lost, what gone from you, what walked away, stole away, run away, thief away. Everybody know what bodies are there for. You have a great testimony. Let God begin the restoration in your life. I want someone to take a pause right there and say, thank you, Jesus, for what you're doing. We'll come to church in a minute. So this Lazarus was sick here. This was not, like I said before, not no ordinary people. The author was deliberate in how he placed it. Amen. In the second verse, he said it was the same Mary which anointed the Lord with ointment and wiped his hair, his feet with her hair, whose brother was sick. Sometimes they say, Pastor, I've sown, I've given, I've prayed, I've done all I can do, and still hell come to my house. Well, I submit to you, praise God, that hell in your house, you are able to deal with hell. I submit to you, praise God, that fire in your house, you are able to deal with the fire. If you know, praise God, all the hell you're going through and you're still here, brother, baby, I know one time, I'm thanking the Lord for bringing you through. Praise my God. And so, amen, the same Mary who anointed the Lord, who sowed her seed, who gave her offering, who gave her tithe, and the same Mary who watched, amen, the enemy come in and afflict her brother Lazarus. Amen. Therefore, the sisters stand and they begin to call the Lord. And here's how they penned the letter. They go to them and say, Lord, him whom you love it is sick. Here's another point. Amen. The fact that you're going through don't mean that God don't love you. I would encourage someone with a love letter from the Lord. Amen. No matter what you're going through, love of God is still on your life. There's some things was done to you, and there's some things you done. But the Lord is still in love with you. The Lord is still in love with you. I better believe God never did tell him, Lord, God is still in love with me. I know that you're a person, but I know the Lord loves me. I know he does. Oh, God, yeah, I ain't got what I want yet. But praise God, he done enough. Praise God, the shallow they love. So I know the Lord loves me. I seen some things I should have gotten killed in, and he bring me out of it. I should have gone, amen, destroyed him. I know how he must love me. All I said, I praise God for the love I know he got for me. I want someone to praise God. You know that God loves you. You know that God loves you. In spite of what's going on, you know that you know that you know the Lord loves you. Somebody, yes.
Yes, Jesus
loves me. Yes. So he said, him whom you love is sick. God, my second observation here, amen, even though you know Jesus, amen, it doesn't give you amen, the right to sit or to sing that he coming when you call him. Even though you know Jesus, amen, and have given him your best, he still ain't got to move when you call him. Come on, somebody here. Because folks trying to buy you sometime, God, let me hear. Because they give you something, and bless you or something. They say, when I call you, you gotta come. Come on, somebody, amen. But understand, prayer, sometime the Lord put you in a holding pattern. And some of you, praise God, from December of last year, you've been in a holding pattern. I tell you, praise God, that God is about to give you clearance to come down. Lift your hands and praise and give the prayer. Let me say it again. Some of you have been, I heard him say it, some of you have been in a holding pattern, and the whisper was telling you that God ain't going to hear you. God ain't hearing you. And God hearing you. Why? This ain't changed yet. But honey, the change is on its way. You're about to get a call from control tower and say, you're clear for that day. Don't know the Holy Ghost talking to you here. Praise God. But lift your hands and say, I'm clear for that day.
Clear for landing.
I would say you by the Holy Ghost, the pavement is done. Amen. The temple is ready. You're not going to sit in the time not long. You have done your waiting in the atmosphere. And now that God will bring you down, you're going to jump off and begin to access. Amen. With God is calling you to preach, Pastor Miller. But Bernie Cowper, then my second observation is, amen, that your issues do not put God in a panic. I'm saying it again, your issues don't put God in a panic. Because sometimes you say, Lord, you can't see me, Lord. What's up with you, Lord? You panicking, but not God. You know why he declares, I know your ending from your beginning. If you would calm yourself down, you'll realize that you're going to be here for a season after a while. I'm going to break the devil off of you and pull you out. But oh God, preach, Pastor Miller. I encourage myself. I was on the salt banks. As a fisherman drifted for day number one, the men start to panic. And I said, I'm going to go to sleep. Why? We're going to be here for 3 days. I ain't going to panic myself. I ain't going to hurt. They said, I was scared and I was depressed. No, I was not. I got a word from the Lord. You could be here for 3 days. I was in the boat with a Jehovah's Witness and an atheist. Who pushed back. And I said, God, we're going to be for 3 days. I'm going to bed and lay down. I'm going to eat my mango skin, drink some rain water, and go on back. And sure, the third day, amen, we were found and back in time in 3 days. If you know how long the process is, you can relax yourself and wait on God. I hope you could say somebody here. Amen. Lord, asking God all kind of questions. Say, Lord, how long is this night? Oh, God, I feel like preaching there. They say, weeping in door but for a night. But the question is, how long is the night?
Oh,
you better pack your bag of faith. You better pack your bag of prayer. And pack your bag of praise to endure your night. Because when you feel restless, you don't call nobody to help you. You get up on yourself and get praise God, because you know it could be a long night. Say, preach, Pastor Miller.
Preach, Pastor Miller.
And so, amen. Say, neighbor, your issues don't put God in a panic. You better calm yourself down and wait on God. Please take one snapshot of which way you are. And the snapshot is, if this thing came to kill you, you'd have been dead a long time. And so, the fact that you're still breathing, wait. I say on the Lord, wait on the Lord, wait on the Lord. You see, then when they told Jesus that Lazarus was sick, he prophesied. He declared the truth. He said, the sickness is not unto death. Please say it 3 times.
The sickness is not unto death.
Say so.
Now
put your own resume there and say, what I'm dealing with is not going to kill me. Oh God, please, my God. You know what got me there on that noise? Amen. I preached for a long time. I have to examine, amen. What does Jesus say? What is he saying to Martha and Mary and Lazarus? The sickness got unto death. And so I put 2 words, amen. I put, amen, the sickness and to death. And I realize, praise God, amen, the sickness really is to be afflicted. But Lord, what does it mean unto death? And so I look at the text. The text said, put the Greek word pros. Pros, amen. It's a preposition of direction forward or to go forward. All right, let me make it plain to you. I feel like preaching this. Okay, now I give you 2 verses. Any two. Stand right there. Quickly, one. To be there. All right, praise the Lord. All right, you stand side by side. Side by side. You got a white leg. Yes, Lord. So you stand side by side now. Amen. Just give us some space between the two of you. brother God, friend. Now you let you get up. Amen. Then something hits you and you're heading in the direction. Pause, not to pause. Now, as you're concerned, this is unto death. The destination or the direction you're walking in is unto death. What Jesus is saying, you're gonna be going towards death, but you're gonna be going towards the glory of God. God, I picture this now. Now as you get to progress, the enemy thinks he's gonna take you to death with the affliction. But God's gonna cause you to be redirected over to the glory. I don't know what you're gonna talk to. Amen. What you gonna do? It's not going to destroy you. It's not going to hurt you. It's not going to kill you. Can I tell somebody, praise God, tonight, watching my live stream, that what you're going through is not unto destruction. It's to the glory of God, preach, man. If I feel like preaching here, it's unto the glory of God. Look at neighbor and say, neighbor!
Neighbor!
It's not going to kill you. Give me some more to start to talk to my child. And say, neighbor! This thing ain't going to kill you. But God will be glorified in it. Give God a praise up in here. God bless you. And so he said, this sickness, your destination is not unto death. I don't know why I'm prophesying to, praise God, but you will not be destroyed in this. You will not die in this. This won't take you down, won't take you out. As a matter of fact, it's going to take you up and take you forward. But when the enemy see where you end up, where you become, they're going to jump there with a gun jump. Look, because the glory of God is about to revive some of your future. About to revive some of your position. What you're in right now look like it's going to take you out. But it's not unto death. It's to the glory of God. Somebody praise him. Give me praise. Lord, you begin this place. And so, praise God, amen. Let me understand, he's not panicking, that this sickness not unto death, but for the glory of God. And what it is to do, praise God, was, amen, to prolong his death. The Bible said, after he heard, amen, that Lazarus was sick, he abode 2 days more. Oh, God, someone said, Lord, where are you? He's hanging out, waiting on you. Some patience. You about to make sure, amen, you got patience. Hallelujah, grab your duke of yours. Amen, God, let me hear. Amen, so he wants you to have some patience. And then he said to the boy, he said, Lazarus is dead. And I am glad for your sake, because I'm going to increase your faith. I want you to look at the neighbor in the eyes, and your faith is about to be increased.
Your faith is about to increase. Amen.
It's about to increase. Tell him your faith is about to be long in this battle. Your faith is about to increase. Your faith is about to increase. I will find one person, praise God, to rest his word in your bosom. Your faith is about to increase. 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 Amen. The things you're going through, amen. The things that walk away from you. The things that left your life. Amen. What the devil meant for bad. Preaching my Lord, amen. God will turn around for good. Don't know the Holy Ghost talking to her. Amen. But God is going to turn some things around. I feel a midnight turn. That midnight this evening. I feel a midnight turn. That the power of God is going to come down in somebody's neighborhood, in somebody's house, in somebody's room. I begin to turn some things around. If you want God, Holy Ghost, come by here, Lord. He said, Lazarus is dead, and not for your sake, to the intent that you might believe. There's a neighbor, it's not too hard for God to bring back saved. Nothing is too hard for God to bring back saved. Nothing is too hard for God to bring back you. And the text is now when Jesus comes into town. And among the missing at the first place, I think it's my attention here. Let me preach his word. God, God, hallelujah. Come on, come on, man. You be merry. Come on, you be merry. You be merry. Come on, man. And then that way, the lady ready. Now, Mary was the one who sat at Jesus' feet. And the midwife Martha was so busy working in the house. Mary was sucking up the anointing. You know, there's a little prayer called music. She always said, church, she always talked, always said prayer. Why? Because it's just drinking up the anointing, it's drinking up the word. So Mary had a closer relationship than the three. Between Martha, Mary, and Lazarus, Mary was the closest. But something, amen, affected Mary after Lazarus died. I wonder why, go back to your seat. I wonder why Mary wasn't the first one to come see Jesus. But come on, Shelly, you be Martha. But Martha, when she heard that Jesus was coming, she didn't get time to reach. She went to meet him halfway. She began to have a conversation with Jesus. And she said, I know, Lord, get me a woman to show. If you had been here, I'd rather would have died. And Jesus said, what word to her? Sometimes go and ignore your influence and ignore your conversation. Sometimes when people jump on you, don't answer them according to their folly. Just keep speaking the word. He said, what your brother shall never be. Martha began to go on the skips of move now. But Martha now is in three tense. She's in present tense. She's in past tense. And future tense. I will tell you.
Yes.
Amen. I will tell you, Martha is innocent on this tense move. Martha said, amen. And then Martha answered Jesus, said, amen. If you'd been here, my brother would have died. Amen. But then she wanted a present tense. Somebody said,
But now.
She said, but now, even now, whatsoever, I'm going to tell you to, whatsoever you ask the Father, he give it to you, in present tense. And Jesus said to her, okay, your brother shall rise again. Now she flips now on the present tense. She said, nothing unto him. I know that he shall rise again. She called it to future tense. I know he shall rise again in the resurrection. And Jesus shut that down. I am the resurrection. In other words, we're going to go to the resurrection. I brought resurrection to you. That's the word for somebody here. Go and fast forward some things just for you. He will speed the process just for you. I want 9 places, praise God. We want to fast forward the process to say, yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, yes, Lord. Will get present tense because she said, I know it's going to happen. Oh God, but you got to stabilize yourself. You got to stabilize yourself. Her past tense was, if you've been here, my brother would have died. But if don't count no more, he died. She was the present tense. Whatever you ask God, he will do it for you. Amen. And she was holding that thing right then. And then he said, okay, what's going to happen? I'm going to ask God to bring him back. She's like, when he's coming back, coming back later. I want someone, praise God, so I'm going to get my faith stabilized. I'm going to be walking 1 minute in a past tense, and then in a present tense, in a future tense. I'm going to stabilize my faith. I'm going to stabilize my mind. And I'm going to walk in a now faith. I want someone, praise God, who will walk in a now faith to lift your voice one more time and say, come now, faith. Come now. Come now, come now. He said, I am the resurrection. And then she heard him, she praised God, she ran and called Mary. She going to call Mary now. And he came to Jesus. And she came and she took her position. She sat by his feet. But this time she got internal issues. Oh God, please ask me. You know why God even moved some people? Because their mind messed up and they so they spirit on jacked up because they come out of connection with God. Mary come back to Jesus, knowing who he is, and still someone might have said, if you've been here, she went to past faith. If you've been there, everybody would have died. He said to both of them, I'm telling you this thing. If y'all could believe, you would see the glory of God. I'm saying to somebody on the side of my voice, if you can believe, you shall see the glory of God. Now, I know you got just a delight to come to Sunday night infusion service just not to get something from the Lord. If you come to fight for that which you lost and come to bring it back, say, Lord, I believe.
Lord, I believe.
I'm going to say 30 seconds right there. Lord, I believe. I'm going to get get your faith in Brother Pastor, out of Past Pastor, out of Egypt Pastor, and put your faith in now, God. Put your faith in today, God. Put your faith, you got the word in your home. You got the word in your heart. You got the word in your mind. Say, Lord, now.
Lord, now.
Say, Lord, now.
Lord, now.
Say, Lord, now. I will break a demon off your soul. Say, Lord, now. I feel the power of God. Say, Lord, now. Open your mouth if you want it now. I believe a miracle. I feel the presence of God. Looking for a place to rest. Looking for a place to abide for the night. Anybody praise God for the glory of God. So assemble out in your house, in your bosom, open your mouth and say, now, Lord. I want to hear now. And now from your soul. And now from your heart. There's a miracle waiting on you now. There's a move waiting on you now. There's a breakout waiting on you now. Open your body, Lord. Now! Call it now.
Now!
Call it now.
Now!
Call it now. You're not forgetting. You can't see it. You said, check me. My question tonight from the Holy Ghost to all of you watching or in this room. Do you believe that what God said he would bring back to you will come back? You might not get the same one, but you will get the same thing. Honey, I'm prepared. My doors are open. My bags are ready. So when God began to do it again, I'm ready. My faith is so high, and I'm looking for God to do it. I'm looking for God to restore me back. There was a day my house mortgage was out of zero. I'm looking for God to do it again. I want to praise God. I'm looking for God to do it again. Say, now, Lord.
Now, Lord.
Now, Lord. Now, Lord. I've got to run. I've got to run. Do you believe? Ask him. Do you believe? Ask him. Do you believe? Do. Do. Ask him. Do. Ask him. Do you believe?
I believe.
Do you believe? No, I mean get real out to do.
Do you believe?
Ask him. Ask him. Amen. Do you believe? Do you believe? Take the water off. Take the water off. Take the water off. Do you believe? Ask him. Do you believe? Ask him. Do you believe? Do you believe? Now, if you believe, yeah, the first thing you got to do, amen, you got to show the one that you believe. Amen. You got to show the how. He says, show me where you made him. Amen. Go back and tell God what you lost. Amen. Those of you know, you know, you know. And some of you, praise God, you gotta go back home to your house tonight and get up in your secret place and pour yourself out to God. And say, Lord, this is my lost love. This is my lost. This is my lost. Oh, God, I think you're blessed. This is my lost. I'm the Lord bidding tonight. Anybody up here got a real, real desire for returning? If you would know how to return, check time. Let me get a prayer. Thank you. crazy. You gotta break that situation. Cause there's some things you got to break. Now, I tell you, first God, there's some